diabetes. So coming to the case of the next thing, when there is a animal, when a cow is presented to you with swelling in the mandible, so when a cow is presented with a swelling in the mandible, how to approach these type of cases? So progressive swelling in the mandible. So sometimes the owner may be reporting a hard swelling in the mandible near the cheek teeth, second or third molar teeth, which is hard in nature and progressing day by day, increasing day by day, and it is progressing as swelling is there. When you palpate, it is very hard in nature. You think about actinomycosis. Okay. When it is a soft fluctuating in the submandibular region, the jowl edema, that is mainly due to hypoproteinemia, that is due to worm infestation. Okay. Sudden swelling in the mandible, a big cut like thing, you have to think about any snake bite, snake envenomation. Okay. Facial edema with the edema in the ears and all, sudden swelling of the eyes, ears and the head and all, you have to think about angioedema, any allergic conditions that is due to any other plant material. That all these things you have to do by clinical examination and narrow down the diagnosis. So facial or mandibular swelling, you have to think about actinomycosis. As already told, actinomycosis is very easy to diagnose. It is hard in nature. It is a progressive swelling. So it won't come on a single day. Okay, you keep it in mind, it won't come on a single day. So the owner will be telling it is there for 1 week, it is there for 10 days like that. So unless otherwise, the snake envenomation, it is a sudden onset. And piton pressure will be there. In snake envenomation, it will be having piton pressure will be there. So hypoproteinemia, jowl edema will be there. The dependent part, a soft fluctuating swelling in the jowl. And in HS, hemorrhagic septicemia, there may be hard swelling in the throat region, submandibular region, with a congested mucous membrane and respiratory distress will be there. Severe respiratory distress will be there in HS. And the edema of the face, the submandibular edema will be there with the jugular vein engorgement will be there. I will show the pictures. The jugular vein engorgement will be there. That is called pericarditis. So by just a palpation and appreciating the clinical sign, you can very easily diagnose the cases within few minutes. See here, there is a hard swelling of the mandible, which will be, when you palpate, it's very hard in nature. When you put a needle, you can able to get a foul smelling fluid from the swelling. And sometimes you'll be getting some sulfur-like granules will be there. That's a case of actinomycosis. Here also, the swelling is very much obvious. The animal cannot able to chew the feed and the fodder thing. And the swelling is massive. So here also, the swelling is very much extensive and particular to the mandibular region, which is hard in nature. It's all actinomycosis. The treatment of actinomycosis, you can give penicillin. So you can give penicillin, large dose of penicillin can be given. So you can give streptopenicillin 5 gram IM or 7.5 gram IM, or if you are giving plain penicillin alone, you can give penicillin, it will be very much effective. With followed by potassium iodate should be given. Potassium iodate 10 gram orally for 10 days. That is the main thing. So potassium iodate is available from the chemical shop. So you have to get it from the chemical shop and you have to give it as a 10 gram, as a 10 packets, you keep it. And daily you can take one packet which is having 10 gram and mix it with some electuary and give it orally. So then only excellent result will be there. Some practitioners, they used to give penicillin alone or antibiotics alone, but they won't give potassium iodate. The result won't be that much successful. And some of the cases it will be having for a long period. I mean more than 1 week, say. I mean it will take more than 1 week. I mean, 7 days to 10 days, it will be there, or it will take some 2 weeks also. It depends upon the intensity of the affection. Sometimes refractory cases, you can go for isoniazid, 2.5 to 5 milligram per kg body weight orally for 30 days. But isoniazid should not be used in case of pregnancy. It should be avoided in case of pregnancy. If the animal is pregnant, you should not use it. Otherwise, you can use it as a sodium added gram per kg body weight, mix it with normal saline and give IV. Repeated at 1 week interval. So that also gives an excellent result. Usually the other antibiotics of preference or chlorpheniclal or oxytetracycline can be also used. But the main thing, we used to have penicillin or streptopenicillin with the potassium iodate will give a very good result for actinomycosis. Once it got ripened, you can open the swelling area and you can treat it as an abscess for the follower. See here, you can able to see the extensive swelling. So here the swelling is from the mandible to the brisket region. Mandible to the brisket region. And here you have to differentiate from actinomycosis and pericarditis. How to differentiate from actinomycosis and pericarditis? In pericarditis, the jugular vein will be engorged. That you have to keep it in mind. animal will be showing positive venous stasis test. How to see the positive venous stasis test? I will show the video. So venous stasis will be showing positive, and when you auscultate the heart, you will be getting abnormal heart sounds. In actinomycosis, venous stasis will be negative, the heart sounds will be normal, so that you can easily differentiate the actinomycosis and pericarditis. If you are having ultrasound facilities, it's well and good. We can appreciate very easily by ultrasound. So since we are attending the cases in the field conditions, we have to equip ourselves by appreciating the clinical signs. So here the swelling is in the subclavicular region, soft, fluctuating in nature. When you palpate it, it is soft in nature. This is due to hypoproteinemia. Thus, see the mucous membrane. The mucous membrane will be blanched in there. So it is due to vermifugation, which leads to hypoproteinemia and jowl edema. So what is the line of treatment? You have to deworm the animal. If the animal is anemic, you have to go for the blood transfusion. If the PCV is below 12, you have to go for the blood transfusion and supplementation of mineral mixtures and supplements and amino acids infusions can be given so that the animal can be slowly bringing back to normal. And here also the same thing, the extensive swelling in the brisket region, and see the jugular vein engorgement is there. So in this picture, you can able to see the obvious engorgement of the jugular vein. In all the clinical cases, don't forget to see the jugular vein. All the clinical cases, just as if you are seeing the temperature, mucous membrane and lymph node enlargement and seeing the rumen motility and asking the owner how about the dung or quantity it is passing, you have to observe the jugular vein in all the cases. Just by seeing the animal from the distance itself while walking, you can make the ensure that whether the jugular vein engorgement is there or not. Okay. So here the bilateral jugular vein engorgement is there. Sometimes you may be giving IV fluids. After giving IV fluids, the IV fluids might have got subcutaneous. So the owner might have pressed or giving fermentation the subcutaneous area, and the next day the animal will be having brisket edema, and this year also there will be edema will be there. That because of subcutaneous administration of fluids. So that will be localized to one area alone. So that edema will be present in one area alone. In pericarditis, the jugular vein will be engorged bilaterally, both the left side and right. The engorgement of the jugular vein will be there. So you have to keep your finger like this. See, here you can able to see the obvious engorgement of the jugular vein. You can prominently able to obviously appreciate the clinical sign. It is a clear case of pericarditis. So you have to keep your hand like this. So you have to keep your hand in the jugular vein. And normally the blood is blowing. See, you keep your hand in the jugular vein. Normally the blood is flowing from the head towards the cardiac chambers. So normal case, there will be bulging in the upper portion and there won't be any bulging in the lower portion. That is negative. How about this case? Here, there is bulging in both upper and lower area. So this is indicative of pericarditis. So here, the venous stasis is positive. So there is bulging in both upper side and lower side, and it is a clear case of pericarditis. Just by seeing this clinical sign, you can come to a conclusion it is a case of pericarditis. Very easy to diagnose in case of field conditions. Okay. So you can able to see the jugular vein pulsating. So sometimes a normal and lean animal, it will be having pulsating, and you correlate with the clinical sign. Here the jugular vein engorgement is obvious and pulsating. You just keep your finger like this and see whether it is showing positive or not. If it is positive, it is clear case of pericarditis. In some cases, the scapula will be like this. The scapula will be spinning towards the outside as if it is very much emaciated. So some owners, they will be reporting it has been sudden onset. So you have to think about a few things. Either any pneumonia is there or not, any affections in the thoracic cavity. And you have to auscultate the lungs and the heart for any abnormal sounds and you rule out pericarditis and foreign body syndrome. All these things we have to rule out in this type of cases. See here the scapula, it is abducted towards, the angle is deviated towards outside, and you can able to see the depression here. So you rule out any affections in the thoracic cavity. So if there is any reticular abscess, by seeing the heart rate, you can able to appreciate there will be elevated heart rate. Tachycardia will be there. So in such a condition, you think about any reticular abscess or pericarditis or pneumonia, all these things you have to think about by doing the clinical examinations. See here, the jugular vein is pulsating. It's not that much prominent, you can appreciate, but by keeping your fingers, we can easily appreciate the positive venous stasis test. just keep your finger and see whether it is bulging or not. It's also a clear case of pericarditis. See, it's bulging here, upper portion, and also bulging in the lower portion. You auscultate the heart, you'll be appreciating the abnormal heart sounds. In the earliest phase, the animal will be having tachycardia. After that, the animal will be having a fluid splash, friction sound will be there in the, during auscultation. And after some days, the animal will be having fluid splashing sound when you auscultate the heart. In terminal stage, the animal will be, you cannot able to appreciate the heart sound. That is called muffled heart sound. Okay. So this is various stages of pericarditis. So in the academic point of the view, many of will be as a students will be, you will be seeing the studying about the slope test. See, this is the slope test. See? The animal is walking down from the slope. Can you able to see the same animal which is having pericarditis, which is walking very freely. Why I am insisting this? No. So these are all for academic point of view alone. By this slope test alone, you cannot able to come to a conclusion. I used to insist that alone, because many of our friends during the discussion, they used to say whenever the animal is coming down the slope very obvious, very easily, so it is negative for any foreign body syndrome. It's not like that. Even if it is having foreign body syndrome, well, the concept is that when the animal is walking down, if it is having pain, the animal will be reluctant to walk. So by that, they used to say this type of slope test is to identify foreign bodies. So don't depend or rely on this slope test alone. This is our wither pinch test alone. These are all the non-specific tests. Okay. This is a case of pericarditis, but walking freely. See, this is a case of pericarditis. See, the brisket edema and the jugular vein engorgement is very prominent. See, the jugular vein engorgement is very, very prominent. See, the brisket edema is very much obvious. Brisket edema is a clear case of pericarditis. But when you make the animal in the slope, it's walking very freely. So you should not have a misinterpretation. Just as it is walking from the slope very, very freely, it is not a case of foreign body. It's not like that. You have to rely on clinical examination. That is what I want to insist to you. Always you want to rely on the clinical examination, like venous stasis positive and auscultation of the heart for appreciation of any other, I mean, abnormal sounds like friction or fluid splashing.